right, so this next video, I think it's our last one of the year, we are expanding logs. So we're looking at expanding logs, expand each logarithm, write those directions. And the problem we're going to do is number 27. So make sure you write that down. That's log base 6 of parentheses xyz to the fourth power. Now that fourth power only applies to z, and that's going to be very important for how we expand. Okay, so write that down, pause the video, and then I'm going to give you my screen, only me, so that I can do the problem with you. All right, so as we said, we are expanding. Here's our example that I just wrote, you wrote as well. There's a nice glare. Okay, good. Everything we wanted. So because we have nothing on the outside, right? We have nothing on the outside. It's all in the parentheses. I want to look at what operation I have. I have multiplication. So in order to expand that, I have to think of what the rule is for expanding when I multiply. How do I expand that? Oh yeah, multiply. I'll just add in between each log, expand. So I have here, all right, that glare's getting annoying, not gonna lie. So I have here log base 6 of x plus, because it's multiplication, I can separate with that addition sign. Log base 6 of y plus, because there's another, log base 6 of z to the fourth. Now I'm not done with that, but that is your first step. So your first step is to decide, am I multiplying, am I dividing, separate like that. Okay, and this is because there's nothing on the outside here. There's no extra exponent. If there was, which I'll show you in a second, there'd be a first step before this. Okay, now I have, the only thing I have to deal with is exponent. Now we have to remember the product rule that just moves in front, right? So it moves it in front, and then my final answer, see, nothing changed. I have log base 6 of x plus log base 6 of y plus that 4, that exponent moves in front, so it's 4 times log base 6 of z. And that's it, guys. That's how we expand. So it's just remembering those rules, those operations, and how to manipulate these, okay? I'm gonna give you a second problem where, like I told you, you have an exponent outside. So this would be example 2. And I'm gonna write it with you. I think that we learn like by watching it happen, watching the magic. So we have log of a over b squared, and then cubed is on the outside. Okay, example 2, we're expanding, expand the log, so I want more than one log here. So the first thing I have to deal with is that 3, that exponent. So I'm moving that in front, so I have 3 times log a over b squared. And now it's just like the last problem, right? I have division though this time, division. So I have to deal with the division. Oh yeah, subtraction. So this is gonna get, you know, this can be a little longer than the other problem. And then because I have a 3 outside, I need parentheses because now that 3 applies to both. So I need the parentheses to be there. So I have log A minus log B squared, okay? Log A, and that 3 is on the outside. There's a minus because there's division. Now, the only thing to deal with is this square value. I have to move it in front of just that part, not the whole thing. So I have 3 parentheses. Log A doesn't change, minus, and then that 2 times log B. That does come out front, just that 2. That 2 from this exponent, it just applies to here, so that's why it's there. So that's one way. And then I've also seen from the very beginning, I've also seen where people distribute the power. And it's not wrong, so I want you to see that. Make sure you have this down because I'm going to erase it because I don't have enough room to have both, unfortunately. Otherwise, I've got my, I either have a really big whiteboard or this like small one. So it's kind of a win. I don't know. It's all good. Okay. So now I'm going to, in this case, and they're both right, by the way. I'm going to apply the exponent first. So I'm distributing that exponent, as a lot of you like to say. So the a cubed is going to be a cubed. B squared cubed, we have to multiply those. Power rule, those exponent rules. So it's log a cubed over b to the 6th because I'm multiplying. Power rule, okay? Now I have division, so I separate, you know, expand the log by subtraction. So I have log a cubed minus log b to the 6th. This might be an easier way, just looking at it, you know? And now all I gotta do is move those exponents out front. Move those exponents out front. So I have 3 times log A minus, move the 6, 6 times log B. And that's it. I don't want to mess with the ink, so I try not to touch the front. All right, so this is the entire problem. Both of those problems are equivalent, so it's not right or wrong. So on your test next class, remember, you know, you could have both of these answers as a possibility. Make sure to select them both, okay? At any point, you know, you can pause the video and watch what's happening. Feel free to reach out to your teacher, whether it's me, Ms. Cognetta, Ms. Fencinelli, for some help, okay? All right, have a great day.